Thanks for staying with us. Let's do some mission stories now. And security is a major challenge confronting health workers at the Zenu Polyclinic in the Punkatamansu municipality of the Greater Accra region. Meanwhile, healthcare workers want adequate logistics provided in order to give quality healthcare to patients.
Zenu currently holds our biggest population. The population in Zenu is about 53,000. The name is a polyclinic, but functionally, it functions as a health center. So currently, Zenu is running the morning and afternoon shift. We have not started the night shift yet because the staff strength we have is not enough. We are hoping to start in the coming month.
The facility is available, but patronage is low. This is a major problem confronting the Zenu Polyclinic in the Punkatamansu municipality of the Greater Accra region.
Brought a lot of nurses in, and then they did home visits to let the people know what they have. And still, they are not coming to the facility. All because there are some question marks. They said when they come, the place has been locked. Yes, and that one woman even said she was having an asthmatic attack. And she came down, the place was locked. So she intended not to come again, rather go ahead. Lights, security was a challenge. And Zenu is a very risky place. And most of the nurses working, almost all of them are females. So there's that fear for them to run the ninth shift.
So the mission team was in the community to find out why some residents are not patronizing the facility.
Imagine me, I say, a hospital kit here. They be a yaria a hammin or semi de co hospital cashier. Committee doctor cashier no massa me a yadia. Me bahoa, abia me check it BP.
To me, the Zenu Health Center is a small clinic. Health workers may not be able to treat me.
I think healthcare workers need to advertise the polyclinic before they will enjoy some patronage. This is not the only challenge confronting healthcare workers.
We are running the facility on a prepay system, which is not really helping. The directorate is doing its best to get us constant supply of electricity because Without constant electricity, there are a lot of things we can do. We can also run the night as we wish to. And then our fridges for vaccines, we have to keep transporting in and out. Then even some of the gadgets we use, our nebulizers and things, we are using, the lights goes off. It's a big challenge.
The furniture wasn't enough to serve the place. Even chairs for the clients to sit on and benches, you know, somebody donated benches, but it's not enough. And they forced their way to get plastic chairs. So we in our own way, you know, anybody who step here, we solicit funds. Currently, this is what we are doing. And then we buy the chairs. Committee members are all part.
Security is a major problem. Weeks ago, thieves broke into the clinic's laboratory and made away with some items. The child welfare clinic is currently held under a tree.
This weighing scale ideally is supposed to have a stand. Yes, but as you can see, there's no stand on it. So we are using the tree to replace the stand. Yes, and that is not ideal, because when you do that, you will not be able to get the accurate weight of the child. The child can weigh, say, 7 kilos. And then when the child comes for weighing, then the weight is not, the scale is not accurate. Then you use that scale to weigh, and the weight says 6 kilos. And then say the child is 1 year. You can classify that child maybe underweight, but ideally this child is supposed to be normal. So using a wrong scale could lead to an inadequate clarification of the child nutritional status, and that one is affecting us a lot.
Drugs, which ideally should be stored on shelves, are currently on the floor.
This is our stores. Normally when drugs come in, you can send out to the pharmacy so that you keep regulating, know how they are going about in our commodities. They are here, ideally should be on shelves, which the directorate is trying to get us one or pallets, but for now we don't have them, so we try to keep them in the boxes where we can monitor them.
Healthcare workers at the Zenu Polyclinic say, despite the challenges they are willing to serve, they however want adequate logistics provided so they can give quality healthcare to patients.
Now, health delivery at a chips compound at Nyakwikope on the Dwarf Island in the Afram Plains north of the Eastern Region is gradually collapsing with the invasion of the facility by bats. This has not only affected healthcare delivery, but the lives of health workers at the chips compound is also at risk. Ajo Adobi Owusu has the rest of the story.
Nyakwikope is about 2 hours' drive on a motorbike after crossing the Volta Lake on a boat. The chips compound in Nyakwikope serves about 3 communities. Residents have to travel about 2 hours to Germany, the nearest community, which is about 7 kilometers, to be able to access healthcare. The bats have almost taken over the entire compound, obstructing health delivery. The mammals have destroyed the ceiling of the clinic, where they assemble while emitting a shrill sound and a bat stench. Community members are not able to access the facility due to the stench that emanates from the center. The only health worker at the facility, Emmanuel Menu, says the bats usually appear at night and attack him, making it dangerous for him to even come out of his room, which is also at the facility.
The stench itself, you can't stay. You have been here for 3 years. At times we get sick and we have to go and seek for medical treatment.
According to the nurse, the car batteries used to generate power to refrigerate vaccines for immunization are all not in good state, compelling him to stop the immunization process.
The battery for the fridge for the immunization has spoiled since October 2017. And there's nothing like that. We have to go to the villages, sleep over, to do immunization for the children. We have been doing this since October 2017, and there is no help from anywhere.
The chief of the community says several attempts to get the bats out of the community have proven futile.
We asked for support, but nobody came. So we decided to engage in communal labor to drive them out, but it did not work.
Also in Nyakwikope, the only basic school, which has 158 pupils, has 2 permanent teachers and 4 voluntary teachers who are paid by the community. This has led to the collapse of the junior high school, which serves about 5 of the surrounding communities.
2 teachers over here taking a class, KG1 up to the level of P6, taking them become a problem. 2 teachers taking all classes. So with that, parents have started transferring their walls to communities like Dropon. Then the SMC chairman is a student of this particular JHS, because of the system of lack of teachers. When they pose them, they refuse totally. And they find means of just leaving the district. That is why the JHS will have collapsed.
The chief of the community said parents refused to pay a contribution of 10 Ghana cedis, which is paid to the community teaching assistants.
The PTA contributes to pay community teaching assistants, but due to economic hardship, some parents are unable to pay.
He therefore called on the district assembly and other civil societies to come to their aid.
And that's all for Mission tonight. Mission is brought to you by Star Ghana with funding from Danida, UK Aid and the EU. Thanks for watching.